All right, it is time to wake up money. It is filing tip Friday, and you know what that means. Tips for a bigger refund. Certified public accountant Bob Martin is here to tell us how recent tax law changes could bring us a bigger check, and we like that.
That's for sure.
All right, so let's start with some of the changes, starting with the recovery rebate credit. Tell us about that one.
Well, there was a recovery rebate that people got last year, and it was $600 per individual, $1,200 for married couples, and $300 for their dependents. Well, if they didn't qualify for the full credit, they have another shot at it this year based on their 2008 income.
So how do you qualify?
Well, it's based on your income level, and a lot of people saw their income go down during 2008. And so it's possible they didn't get it the first time or only got a partial credit, so they'll get the remaining credit on their 2008 tax return.
All right, and there's the additional standard deduction for disaster losses, which is very important, especially for here.
Oh, particularly important. And what happened in the past, if you took the standard deduction, you did not itemize, you could not get casualty loss deduction, and you couldn't get a real estate tax deduction either. Both of these now you can take if you take the standard deduction and you have real estate taxes or a casualty loss.
And how do you get everything together for that one?
Well, what you have to do, you fill out everything like you're going to itemize if you're using a computer program, and the computer program will take the higher of the standard deduction plus your casualty loss, plus your real estate taxes, or your actual itemized deductions.
And talking about real estate taxes also, there's an additional standard deduction for that one, right?
That's correct. It's $1,000 for a married couple up to that, or $500 for a single person. And this is something we've never had before, so it's an additional benefit for people.
Oh, people are going to be very happy about that
one. That's for sure.
I know I will. All right, IRS standard mileage, there's a change here?
Yes, what happened is if you don't want to keep track of all your individual expenses related to your business travel, you can use a standard mileage rate. And they increased it during the year because of the high cost of gasoline and other auto maintenance costs. And it went from 50.5 to 58.5 in the middle of the year. So when you figure your business mileage, you have to split it for the first 6 months and the last 6 months to take advantage of the higher rate.
All right, we got 30 seconds, so I want to get to the last two. IRS moving rate.
That's if you had a business-related move and it was during the last half of the year, you can get 27 cents a mile instead of 19 cents a mile.
That's a big difference.
Yes.
You can add up, right? And home buyer's credit up to $8,000.
Yes, and this one's a little complicated. But if you bought a new home last year, starting in about April, and if you buy one through November of this year, you may qualify for a credit all the way up to $8,000.
That's a great one.
Yes.
They're all pretty good. Thank you so much for coming in.
You're welcome.
Filing Tip Friday and giving us this great free advice with
okay.
A certified public accountant, Bob Martin, Accountant to the Stars.